This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show you how to use TI-83 and 84 calculators to work with linear regressions. So let's start out with a basic linear regression, and then I'll show you some of the options that you have when you use the calculator. So to do a linear regression, you have to have two lists entered into your calculator. If you don't know how to enter lists in the calculator, here's a link to another video that I made showing you how to enter the lists in. Let's look at this calculator and make sure that we've got lists entered. So we'll go to the Stat button, and then I want to press 1 in the Edit column. And I can see that I have, in fact, three lists, List 1, List 2, and List 3. Okay, so let's go out of there, go back to the main menu, and then to get a linear regression, all we do is press the Stat button again, go over to the right, one column to where it says Calc, and what we want is number 4, linear regression. So I'll press the 4. Linear regression appears on the screen. When I press Enter, it's given me this information. What the calculator has done is it took the information in List 1 and List 2. It automatically assumes you want List 1 and List 2, and it's created a linear regression, so it would be a linear equation like y equals ax plus b, or you might think of that as mx plus b, where the a or the m is 4.038 and the b is 0.535. Okay, so this is the basic linear regression. Now, you might be in a statistics class or some other class where you're told that you have to find the r and r squared values. If that's the case, what you're going to want to do is turn the diagnostics function on. This is something you only have to do once as long as you don't reset the calculator. So you do it and it'll just appear over and over again. We're going to press the second button, and then down where the zero is, you see above it, it says catalog. So I'm going to press 0. And it takes me a catalog of the things that the calculator will do. What I want to do is go down to the diagnostics section, the D section. So I press the alpha button, that's right below the second button. I go two buttons down below that and go to the x to the negative 1 button. I have to do this 2 times. I'm going to press alpha again and then x to the negative 1. And you see it's moved me down to the D section. I want to move further down until I come to diagnostic on. I press enter. That command has appeared at the bottom of the screen. I press enter again. And now the diagnostics are turned on. Okay, so let's clear the screen and do the same linear regression that we did before. I'll press Stat, move over for Calc. I want number 4. And now when I do it, it shows me the same information plus the R squared and the R values. Okay, so let's clear that and see what the next option is that we have. This is a nice one. You might want to use the information that you get to create a graph. Okay, so we can have the calculator do most of the work for you automatically. Here's what we're going to do. Once again, press Stat, Calc, and number 4 to get the linear regression command. But before you press Enter, go to this vars button. It's right next to the clear button. Press that. Vars is for variables. We're going to go over to the Y variables column. And then we're going to press 1 for function. And we're going to press 1 for Y sub 1. So it's entered Y sub 1 next to the linear regression command. Now when we press Enter, the screen looks the same as before. But if I go to the Y equals screen, you can see it's entered the information that I had so that I've got an equation, y sub 1 equals 4.038x plus 0.535. Now I can look at this as a scatter plot. I'm going to move the cursor up to the very top where it says plot 1 and press enter. Once I've done that, I can move down. You can see that plot 1 is turned on. I go to the zoom menu, and down towards the bottom of that menu, you're going to see zoom stat. That's number 9. When I press that, it gives me a scatter plot of those points, And it also draws in the line that the linear regression created. So I can see how close those points are to the linear regression line. Okay? Now, this part is important. When you're done with this, it's a good idea to turn that plot function off. Turn plot one off by moving up to it, pressing enter again, and then cursor down to make sure it's off. Sometimes when you leave it on, you'll find it interferes with other graphic functions and you get error messages. Okay, so that's how you deal with the scatter plot part of it. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is you might find that you want to use lists other than list one and list two. Let's see how to do that. So once again, we'll go back to the main menu. I'll clear that. I want to start with linear regression, so I'll go to Stat, over to Calc, and number four. But now let's say I want to tell it to use list two and list three. Well, you see above the number two, there's a L2. So I'm going to press second and two, and that'll put L2 in there. That's telling the calculator that the first list we're using is L2. We need a comma, and then we wanted L3, list three, for the second list. So I'll press second and list three. If I wanted to, I could also put a comma in again and put in Y1 if I wanted to see it. Actually, let's do that. I'll put in a comma, go to variables, go over to Y variables, hit the function Y1. Okay, so now the calculator is going to take list two and list three and do a linear regression with them and put the information into Y1. Let's see what happens. Okay, so there's the A value, the B value, the R squared value, the R value, and nicely, I don't have to copy these long, long numbers into the Y equals function. I can just press that button, and there they are in their formula already. Okay, so that's about it. Get some practice with this. It's really a fairly simple process once you get used to it, and it's really convenient. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.